Health Show, and today we are at the Hippocrates Health... No, just kidding. You guys remember Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure? It's Hippocrates. It's Hippocrates. All right, Bill and Ted? It's Hippocrates. But we're here at the Hippocrates Health Institute, and we got a chance to talk to Brian Clement. He talked to us in this very specific segment about three things that are absolutely important to your health. Check it out. So, Dr. Clement, you've been doing this for a lot of years.
40 now.
What have you found to be the most effective in terms of a long-term health protocol and for a particular degenerative disease?
Well, when it comes to the most important thing, it's attitude. Mm-hmm. Because if a person doesn't have a positive attitude and a purpose for life, they find a way to get sick on some level. But then if you talk about the biology, the science of it, the chemistry is very simple. You have 95 trillion cells in the body, and those cells have to have stabilizing foundations. And every cell, the foundation is protein. And so we have to continually be ingesting food with massive protein in it. And if we don't do that, we're in big trouble, major trouble. And the foods that have by far the most protein in it are foods that have the most sunlight in it. It's a very simple thing to understand nutrition that we should be teaching from kindergarten through PhD programs. And it's that the food that captures the most UV rays from the photosynthesis process also have the most nutrients in it, also have that foundation, that base, that protein, amino acid base. Now, the three foods that are the center or the core of the Hippocrates program that we developed over the last 54 years and have applied now for well over a quarter of a million people in a clinical research setting are sprouts, and sprouts out of all land-based foods are by far the most nutritious foods. And there's a wide variety, and what's really remarkable to us is starting in the early 90s, a lot of research has moved into the direction of speaking about the significant phytochemistry in sprouts. So you have an added attraction. Besides being an enormous protein source, it has this phytochemical element that kills and prevents disease and premature aging. Next would be algae, blue-green algae, from the freshwaters, green as well as blue-green, and both of these are the highest foods or the highest plants of protein on the planet. Blue-green's approximately 54% protein, green 52%. Just to make a comparison, in a vegan community ideology, it would be 25% protein from a chickpea sprout is enormous. Mm-hmm. You have more than double in these. They also are the very first life forms on this planet, meaning that they created the foundation of all life as we know it because they spawned oxygen. Right. That's where it came from. And with that said, they have every single element we've so far discovered in nutritional science, plus many more we haven't discovered. So the foundation is there, and the foundation is basically the way it's going to be. Mm-hmm. Number three, it would be saltwater algae.
Okay.
And they were the second life form on the planet. And you're talking about things like arami, hazuki, dulse, nori, wakame, and they should be consumed in their raw form, of course, soaked. And these are the three basic elements. Now, when people are listening, they're saying, well, I don't want to just eat algae and grass. We're saying that this should be the core. And as long as every day you're consuming these types of foods in adequate amounts, and then what we call the condiments, the organic vegetables, if you're healthy, a little bit of organic but ripe fruit, because no fruit, including organic fruit, is picked ripe. So that acts as a magnet for nutrition. All unripened fruit sucks nutrition out of the body. And all the fruit today has been hybrid to be approximately 30 times, not percent, 30 times higher in sugar. And so what we know is that blood sugar, sugar in the blood that's not being ingested by the cell, and three major foods for the cell are oxygen, essential fatty acids, and also what? Sugar.
Mm-hmm.
But you get the adequate amount for the cell to be fed from lettuce. You don't need it from a fruit that's 30 times higher in sugar than its origin fruit thousands of years ago. So with that said, what you have to understand is we go back and look at blood sugar as being an element of disease creation and disease multiplication. And this is not only an idea that we, thank God, stumbled upon some 30 years ago through Edie Mae Hunsberg, who basically was the woman who put Hippocrates on the map. It wasn't our founder, Ann Wigmore, God bless her for what she did, or Victoria Skolvinskis, or my wife or I. It was Edie Mae Hunsberg, who wrote a wonderful book 35, 40 years ago called How I Conquered Cancer Naturally. And that book literally sold 1 million copies. And when I became director in 1980, I did a little poll and I said, well, how did you get here? And 65% of the people literally came through reading that book.
Really?
Now, what was interesting with her she was one of those people who, like me, were interested in the scientific reason this was happening. Of course, we were applying it. It was working. It took her cancer away. I was feeling like a totally different human being, like a human for the first time. But we really didn't have the science on it. We had some innuendo and some ideas, but we weren't really correct. She was doing science. Mm-hmm. And who she was doing it was with, interesting enough, was a young Phi Beta Kappa graduate from Stanford who was running the Linus Pauling Foundation,
okay,
called Dr. Arthur Robinson. And what they came up with is that sugar, when she consumed a lot of dates, as an example, organic dates grown in Southern California where she resided, her cancer tumors started to grow. Date season was over, stopped eating dates, cancers went away. And when she said this to me, it was shocking because probably at that point, like most raw food devotees in the early stages, half my diet was fruit.
Right.
Because I didn't really want to abandon my addiction of sugar, so I just changed the channel. Mm-hmm. And so rather than white sugar and honey and all of the things, I changed the channel to, you know, pineapples that were dried and dates that were dried. So reluctantly, because I didn't want to believe what I was thinking I was going to find, and I did find, literally, I went into this and did a study, very quiet. We couldn't do anything open in those days because the FDA was on a yearly visit to us in mm-hmm. Boston. And I found the people that I took off the sugar were flourishing, the people I didn't.
Right.
We're not. And so we took carrot juice, beet juice 30 years ago, all fruits out of the diet of anyone who has microbes, that's bacteria or viruses or certainly fungus or yeast, and certainly mutagens, cancers of any type, low sugar, blood sugar, or diabetes. Mm-hmm. And boy, from that point forward, we saw instantaneously, it was like going from white to black, or black to white. Boom, here it was, just in front of us.
Right.
And so now, in those days, we were considered renegades. Today, there's not a legitimate oncologist or legitimate doctor that I know that doesn't speak about this to his patients, even if they're mainstream doctors today. There's not anyone who doesn't understand that exceptional sugar in the blood attracts and multiplies diseases, viruses, mold, yeast, fungus, cancers, etc. As a matter of fact, Johns Hopkins just put a report out. It's as if I penned it, telling people what to eat and what not to eat, and fruit was off the list for those people. The other thing is I'm in the middle of a 3-volume series on food as medicine, and I've been collecting literally all the research, which I'm surprised how much there is actually today. You know, you think you know something until you get into it deeply. And one of the chapters I'm going to write in this 3-volume series is about how sugar ages you. And
okay.
I don't care if it's fruit sugar, or I don't care if it's... So we go back to the protein. Protein mm-hmm. is basically what you need. It's not as tasty. It doesn't feed your addiction. And nobody likes it as much. It's not as sexy.
Right.
But the reality is it works.
Your question of the day, what are the 3 things that are important to you? Go ahead and post it down below. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Pass this along. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.